Welcome to the stream of Hot Chili versus Brisbane Mammoth. This is quarterfinals, Australian Ultimate Championships 2017, Runaway Bay. We're in for a huge game here. Two big teams, big squads, physical squads, with some sharp play. We've got on both sides, we've got veterans, we've got rookies, and very athletic players on both sides. Expecting a big contest here. Both teams coming through pool play fairly well, building their game. And looking for a big result here. We're going to have Mammoth coming out on offense, starting the game from the right-hand side of the screen, Chile to the left. And wind at the moment, it's a breeze heading to the left shoulder of the camera. I welcome to the commentary box. Chris, welcome.
Thank you. You excited for this one?
I'm very excited. I saw this on the schedule and knew this would be top-notch game. Two teams really, really into it.
A lot of history between these two teams as well. They've met in the numerous pre-quarters.
Absolutely, and BCI final rematch that got cut short.
Indeed, that went 3-2 to Mammoth.
McNaughton pointing direct in traffic. He's looking downfield. Crossfield. Big throw, it's up. Oh, Joker pulls down the early score. Quick offense and a sneaky dab to add.
Jolie, right place, right time there.
Yep, floating over the heads. I'm not sure your claim intended receiver, but that doesn't really matter in the end.
No, that's right. It's always the result that matters.
Chris, how's the tournament looking from your end?
Yeah, it's been going pretty well. Fairly uneventful in terms of things going wrong.
Yep, your role as?
TD.
Yep.
So we've only had one person taken away in the ambulance so far, and one other hospitalisation that I'm aware of. So.
And that's the perspective of a TD, looking to the logistics, making everything tick, making everything happen.
Yeah, good times. Got good infrastructure here this year, so I'm pretty happy with that, and I think most people are, but that's solely based on the few people that I've spoken to. But ultimate players are pretty well renowned for letting you know if they're not happy with something, so there's been not really much of that, so
yeah, good. No news is good news.
Yep, that's how I'm playing it.
As a Queenslander, you're all over Mammoth play today.
Yeah, absolutely. Played with Mammoth's D2 squad last year before. So it's really exciting to see them in their third year make it all the way up here. John McNaughton with one of his ridiculously magical pulls.
Baker collecting the pull. Centres to DeBell, a young player from Monash. Line veteran Allen. Pops it to DeBell, looking eager. Scoobers to the space.
Ooh.
Too eager.
Linus with the pickup to John McNaughton, looking deep to Treno, back to John McNaughton, he's calling him back under. We have a call.
Pick called.
Bit difficult to see the advisors with all the players on the sideline, but. Dan McPherson, Al Least sends it, Big Trent, is he in? Yes.
Well, that's two scores to Mammoth. Don't you worry, Chile's not panicking yet.
Trent Thompson coming up with the goods there for Mammoth. Beautiful little jump into the end zone there. Good way to start a game, 2-0.
Well, from the Mammoth's perspective, for sure.
Absolutely.
And they're up and about. There's a lot of energy.
Yeah, it's good. Pretty big squad. 26 players, I think they got on their roster this weekend. down to 25. Marcus Lee's scout with a shoulder injury.
Still, that's still plenty of legs.
Yeah. Yep. Be really excited to see if that strategy sort of plays off with them. I mean, back in the days, it didn't necessarily hold true. I think, 2010, Newcastle won with 13 players?
The infamous 13.
Yep. The squad's nearly double that size.
Yeah, and, well, yeah, it is.
Yeah, so.
Game becoming more and more athletic.
Yep. Oh, Timocles Copeland with a massive pull.
Oh, they've got a job to pull that in. Quite fairly, DeBell lets that go to ground first. Junker, central zone. Gaki returned it to Junker. Chile often looking more dangerous when they have Rugaki outside of the handler positions. Playing as that receiver. That's when you know they're switched on. He will fall back when needed, though.
Is there a foul? Yep.
Strip called. Strip. Uncontested. DeBell moving the disc on. Baker to the space.
Oh, Liam Grubin!
Huge! Early nomination for the highlight reel there. Look, you come to expect it from Grimmond. And I just wouldn't put it to his space anywhere near him.
Oh, and Guck gets big. And I'm assuming he didn't catch it.
No.
I can't actually see.
Chile with another shot. It's offense. The hammer across field to the space. Junker collecting. Bullet to Allen. That connection made many, many times. Allen looking across field. He's Gak. Rugaki there. He wants
big
him,
pressure.
But that zone defense working very effectively. Just about popping through Baker. He is an experienced one. Casta Blanco. Rugaki. Aggressive mark from McIntyre. Baker. Hammer across field. Open up the space. Junker with plenty of time. But no one to follow on with. Gaki's ankle's a long way from his hands there. He was that height. He pulls it in. Baker looking, pops it through the space. It's patience. Very mature frisbee. Gaki in the corner. Pops it through to Junker. Taking his time. Allen playing an aggressive position there in the wing. Oh, that's a high disc, but Allen able to collect. Space to DeBell, through to Baker. The options shut down that defense. Hustle. Hit.
Oh, uncharacteristic drop there by Pete Allen. Mammoth defense not giving up at all.
So much hard work.
As young Tom Anderson there, I think, with the D.
Was it a D or a clean drop?
Chile get it straight back.
Junker hot on Kirkland's heels, and he gets the score as well, the double happiness.
That was a lot of composure there, a lot of throws. Chile able to put it in.
Sigh of relief. To move down the end 3-0. That looks slightly more formidable. If that Mammoth
should be 2-1, isn't it?
It's 2-1 now. Yep. Chile scoring there. Obviously Mammoth having the shot at the end zone, going down. Go Mammoth! Michaela Combe on the line, handling this line, player coach, giving instruction. He's a key player on this defensive line.
couple of rookie players on this Mammoth line. My eyes don't deceive me. Rob De Hollander, Dan Mack, with some strong veterans on there as well. Seb Brown, Chris Brown, John Norton. They also got young Stu as well.
Stu Jinx.
Seb Brown collects it up, sends it to John McNaughton.
Pick call.
John McNaughton puts it to Chris Brown. Stu Jinx is there. Recent Australian under 20. Gets it back to John McNaughton. John McNaughton, Sam Guckin. Beautiful. Beautiful low release there to the break side. Wonderful.
The throw power of McNaughton showed on that point. Two throws opening up the field. Big gainers. He's got all that athletic capability in that line. You called it earlier that there was a few rookies. It's a team full of run. Gee, if you got that throw, you'd be pretty happy with the receivers on his team.
Indeed. I guess that's the benefit for throwing for over 15 years. And a Marcus Leask approaches the commentary position. Gives us a little bit of a Tinkerbell wave. Thanks, mate. Yeah, boys.
Let's go, boys. Offensive line of Baker, Castablanco, Rigaki, Allen, Kelly, DeBell, and Junker. We saw in the first game streamed here, the very, very first game on Saturday, these two teams first up then.
Oh, we got a pull up.
And we saw a regular connection between Rigaki and Kelly made. Side stack and pull here. Baker floating in that zone. Taking care of that that set play.
There's definitely a lot of speed in that Mammoth defense there.
Big aggressive hammer. That Perry mentioned.
Oh, it's just Kelly. Fingertips to it. Elliot Cook picking up, finds our lease, partner in crime. Trent Thompson, looking for the easy reset. Back to our lease, puts it deep. Who's back there, Lockbond? He's chasing. Can't quite pull it in.
Drifting on that breeze. Definitely don't have a strong breeze here on this field as we did yesterday, but it's still affecting.
You get that outer edge up, she will catch and float.
Beauty of a Rigaki-led offensive line. High reward, high risk. Have another shot at this. Blanco stuck. Gets the dish to Bell. Sees the space to Baker. Excellent at finding spaces. Rigaki moves that cup with a fake. Across the field to Junker. Playing a key role so far early on. Joel Cook wondering if he had a sniff. Baker again. Again across field. A little bit tougher for Junker. Safe hands though. That zone working very hard. A lot of noise coming from the sideline. Very keen on this defense. Pulls the cup wide with the fake. The disc is up to the space. Allen going. The question was whether he got his hand there first, but it didn't really matter as it bobbles out. Injury called. Steve Thomas called on.
Mammoth with the disc, at least walking it up. Sends to Cookie. Trent Thompson looking to offload. Sends it back to Elliot Cook, sends it to Linus. Puts it deep to Al Leisk. Doesn't quite pull it in.
Steve Thomas giving Mueller a lot of room on that undercut, allowing him time to pick up the disc, turn and shoot without a tight mark on. That would have been costly if it connected. Over the top to DeBell, opens up the field. He always looking central. DeBell's always keep it just moving. Seen Rigaki here multiple times, he's gone for the hammer.
Foul
call.
Everyone ready?
Uncontested, coming in the line. Big throw up to Kelly.
Linus. Linus with a big D there.
It looking like he had a good good amount of disc there.
Mm.
It's up. It's high. Connection.
Elliot Cook. Looking for options. It's going to be getting high, that stall count. Goes to Lock Bond. Back to Elliot. To Ryan Garrahy. Back to Elliot Cook. Linus Mueller. To Lock Bond in the corner.
That's the break.
Toes it in.
They open up that score line. Just that little bit more. 3-1.
3-1 or 4-1?
We'll confirm.
There's a scoreboard over there. Thank you, Seb Brown, for changing the scoreboard for us. It is 4-1. Definitely the hero the ultimate community needs. Looks like another very quick and fast Mammoth D-line coming up. Dan Mack, Dan Gladish, Lock Murph, Finn Powley, Alex Sims, Al Leese, and John McNaughton with the beautiful floaty pull.
Gladish, one of my favourite to watch with his intensity. This offensive line going again, Lepari added. Pentland joining them. DeBell keeps the disc moving very well, keeps it very aggressive through the centre. Baker round to Lepari. Oh!
Oh, the defense doesn't make it,
but it's a grab.
What a bid.
Big bid from Murphy, not enough to stop the score.
4-2. Chile are liking that shot. We've seen 2 points prior where that hasn't come off, so third time's the charm.
Mike Baker looking key early on for Chile for that offensive line. He's moving well. DeBell looking aggressively, and those two connecting up multiple times.
Lots of quick movement at that point as well. Minimal overheads, just working it through, and then the long punt.
Yeah, maybe that's a template they can use.
So Mammoth O-line looks like C. Brown, Seb Brown, Jack Allen, Tom Anderson, Timocleese Copeland, Sam McGuckin, and Liam McIntyre.
Come on, boys!
Let's go hard! Let's get down there, boys!
Let's go, Mammoth!
Right, this, that's a fantastic pull.
Beautiful pull.
Mammoth working it out of their end zone.
Osman with a big mark.
Lots of give and goes up through the guts. Timocles, oh, look at all that space.
Errant disc they had. Feels the space. Foul called though.
Let's go, Chile! Come on, boys!
Rivenberg in the play.
We all good?
That's with you, yeah.
Sam McGuckin offloads to Timocles. Timocles looking for options. Goes to Jack Allen. Jack sends it to Chris Brown. Chris Brown looking to Jack Allen. Jack Allen. Seth Brown. Over the top to Leon McIntyre. The hammer fake behind the back to Chris Brown. Bit of a cheeky play. I'm surprised people still fall for it.
We saw that yesterday in the stream against this team. He pulled the same trick.
Old man tricks. Always entertaining, I guess. So that's 5-2 to Mammoth now.
It's 5-2 and that wall looking fairly unorganised from Chile, whether it was the quick movements had them scrambling, but a lot of players committed upfield close to the disc, leaving a paddock of space, recovering turned into a match defence, but really Mammoth looking like they were comfortable against that as well.
Yeah, all those short give goes, found a hole, punched through.
With Chile after being recruited from Hoss. DeBell.
What a take.
Thomas picking it up with the roll. Getting the fingers underneath DeBell. Always active. Doesn't want to stop. Reach for the break. Allen coming back. That's a high disc contest.
Oh, Chris Tan comes through.
Rivenberg joining.
I'm standing straight up. You just fouled me.
You were coming back.
I'm standing right here. Oh, it's just straight behind me. You cannot initiate contact. If I have my position, you can't any contact where you are making a play for the disc. And I have that position.
I would say you're holding your hands up.
Yeah, exactly.
And you're falling back.
Yeah, let's just ask.
So I thought you were moving that way a little bit, but I thought that because you've been tripped up over by that guy pushing you towards that way already. So I'm not sure what your call exactly is.
Yeah, I'm calling a foul.
Yep. Yeah. It looked like there was definitely contact that you were involved with.
I mean, there were two I got tripped on, but it was the there that.
Yeah.
But I don't think the disc. No.
So you don't think it affected the play?
I think.
It sounds like it's contested.
Contested,
yeah. So I think we should send it back. Go back to where you were when it was thrown. What's the stall count? Stall count? Maximum six. Coming in on four?
Just seeing this this cup that Mammoth is throwing on, there's a lot of wingspan in there.
A lot of movement, but these players, I think this line's chosen for that reason, that they seem to pierce holes.
Oh, there we go.
Hansland putting it to the defender.
Luke Bain has a disc in hand. Goes to Sam McGuckin. Sam McGuckin punts it. Chris Tan with the score.
6-2.
This is turning out to be quite a challenge for Chile to pull back in now. Certainly not insurmountable, but not ideal by any stretch of the imagination.
Mm. It's timeout called.
I assume by Chile?
Yes.
Mammoth are pumped. They got a lot of good energy right now. They should be pumped right now.
We see Chile's changing that up with their O-line. They're including different players, and on the last couple of O-lines, removing Rigaki, who generally considered a central player there, looking for speedier players, quick movement. They've identified that as a way to get through. It's been turnovers from the throwers so far.
Absolutely.
Well, the other side of the coin being the pressure on that throw.
Yep. That cup that they're running is... It's not really a handler's dream position to be in with that around you. They're finishing the timeout quickly. They want to get back out there as soon as possible.
Yeah, why not? The 6-2, come down now, that same intensity, you'll be moving very quickly towards half.
Yep. Certainly a great start for them for our quarterfinals. Alisk, Elliot Cook, Lock Murph, Linus Muller, Trent Thompson, Alex Sims, and Finn McCarthy.
And Hot Chili going back to their starting offensive line. Thomas, Baker, Rigaki, DeBell, Kelly, Casablanco, Allen. Mike Larson giving instructions there. Haven't seen this game, I'm assuming it's the old calf injury that he carries affecting him. Belt, Casablanco, zone coming down, employed a lot this tournament. Rigaki, seen him in this position multiple times, and he breaks through the cup, and it's like a floaty, floaty disc.
Elliot Cook brings it down.
Around.
Alex is looking. Cool, mate. Alex to Trent Thompson, Trent not being able
Baker's putting himself in that that position to attack that cup. Cast a blanket and bring the disc back in. It's a tight cup once they crash in. The popper. Scooter over the top. Breaks through to Baker. Low, a lot of spin. Don't want to be stuck in the sideline. That's where they've come unstuck multiple times. Rigaki to Casablanco. And it's Gaki chasing that disc. Through to Allen. Keeping that disc moving to Baker. Again, finding the center of the field. Power position. To Bell. Sneaky, sneaky. Baker, the score. DeBell with the assist.
Jack played a pretty big pivotal role in that that point. I think he had had the disc in his hand nearly every second touch.
Yeah, I think he'd be disappointed with a couple options this game. Maybe not options, maybe execution. But breaking the cup multiple times.
Yeah, those overheads are certainly risky with the breeze, which is a bit, it's not a constant breeze, it's pretty gusty.
It's stationed on the close wing, the downfield, downwind wing, while handling, and looking to break it to the centre or upwind as often as they can.
So that timeout helping Chile at that point, you reckon?
Yeah, they look a little bit more switched on. They're veterans playing very, very well. We can expect that. There was early errors, and we expect them to pick up. A key to this game, I think, is whether their second-tier players are going to fill in those spaces when those players aren't on the field.
Massive pull. John McNaughton taking it on the chest. Sinus Elliott Cook. Ryan Garrahy. Linus Muha. Linus to Lock Bon. Back to Elliott Cook. Lock Murphy with the disc. Back to Elliott Cook. Sends it for Linus Muller. Gets big, takes it, and sends Lock Murph.
The young guns play a big part. They're a young team, and very impressive at that point.
Absolutely.
What a argy-bargy in the middle of the field from Lacombe McNaughton, captain to either side. Coaches. What of body contact, and McNaughton was not happy during the point.
So a lot of these younger Mammoth boys were on the Queensland Under 22 squad that took gold medal last year. So they're certainly stepping up to the big stage here.
Yeah, I hear a lot of those players returning for under-22s for the next campaign.
I expect they will.
Yeah, still young players.
Don't know when that is yet, but sometime in November. Timocles Copland with a massive roller.
Casablanco scrambling. Hitting. Junker to Baker.
Ooh.
Multiple grabs at that.
I'm not saying headshot, I'm not throwing a straight.
Yeah,
But I wouldn't say you've got it.
I never said I had control.
Yeah.
Just like my hands just went for it.
But I wouldn't, like the list is here, when I hit your hand, so I don't think you could have got it.
You thought he'd already dropped it when he hit his hands?
And dropped it in the air.
It's right here, it's about to drop.
Yep.
So, yeah.
But he thinks you'd already weren't going to catch it when he hit his hands.
Yeah.
But you think you were.
Yeah, control, he slipped it down out of my hands.
Yep.
I'm not claiming that I had control of it.
Yep. You thought you still had a chance to catch it?
Yeah.
Yep. And you're saying that you don't think you did, so that means it goes back.
I thought he lost it.
I didn't say I had control.
I
just thought
he lost it.
Retracted.
Retracted?
Down?
It's so good to be able to hear that conversation, the players on the screen, but taking the outside perspective and Rigaki retracting that call.
McIntyre sends to Copland back to McIntyre. McIntyre looking for options. Back to Copland. Back to McIntyre, back to Copland. Copland up to Liam Brimond, to Leon McIntyre. Power call.
Uncontested or contested? Uncontested.
Stay on him, left, work him, left.
Leon McIntyre looking. Looks to hit Chris Brown. Pick,
was it a pick? I'm not sure. Maximum six, that's all I know.
Yeah, I'd said seven when the throw was.
Sure.
So coming back in on six. And to Timmy, please. Timmy plays to Sam McGuckin. The score. And that's half. If I'm right, 8-3.
So just a comment on that last call with the Tom Rigaki was involved with the down call. That was really great to see that the players there actually made all the resolutions themselves. So I was just there to help the conversation, but Tom was able to ask other players around him for their perspective, and he took that advice and accepted that the disc was down. So really great display of spirit from both sides there.
Sure, and Ruben, when the disc is returned after the pick, is it always a stall count below six?
Yeah, after a pick call, it's always maximum six.
So, 8-3 to Mammoth, half time. What's the Chile need to do? What do they need to change up?
Oh, it's just got to go all out. I feel like this defense is pretty intense. Whether they can stretch it with a long game. They tried that early on. They've since gone for a bit of a short ball through the center. Looks good, but getting held up at some point, just not coming up.
Yeah, I think when Chile has that momentum with their passes, they seem to be scoring. But as soon as they stall or stutter, that seems to be where the turnovers happen.
And so whether they need to adjust that dump set to get the man behind and look for the big swing.
Yeah.
They look to break the force rather than lose ground.
Yeah.
But really, once they lose possession, Mammoth are brutal on the turn.
Yeah, so much speed and so much height. If they're not even speedy, and some of them have both, which is always a nightmare to mark against. But just so quick to punish. Yeah, they're certainly showing a lot of confidence as well. A lot of confidence, a lot of enthusiasm. Cheers, mate. Thank you, Fausto. Always love a good cookie now and then.
keen no matter what you do.
Welcome back for the second half. We have the scores at 8-3 to Mammoth advantage. Hot Chili to the right of screen coming out on offense. There is the slight downwind behind them, and maybe that's a chance to get one on the board, get some momentum. They're going back to the line that they played a lot together.
Looks like a John McNaughton pull.
He's trying to spread the field to Bell, catching the ball. Baker to Castablanca. Looks downfield, not on that big wall. That's a huge amount of height on that wall.
Yep.
Junker finds it to Bell. Defense has a shot. Castablanca finds Bagacki. Baker streaming, and the hammer goes across to Pete Allen. Oh, so much space. The vision. Pops it to Castablanco.
There we go, Chile starting strong. 8-4 to Mammoth. I guess that's the thing with the overheads, right? High risk, high reward.
Yes. Going into the breeze. So much spin on that disc that if it comes out of the hand right, that's a fantastic throw. And I mean, really, even if it did trail a little bit, Allen was on his own on that wing.
Absolutely. Yeah, he had lots and lots of space around him. And he's going to make a bid for it if he has to. So you've got a lot of room for error when you throw to someone like Pete. Gak had that with precision, there was no need to.
Yeah, I think they were wise in their setup. They let their give-go players take control of the point early,
yep.
Work out what was happening with the zone and where the space was. Before they found the gap, Rogacki found on his own on the wing. And he had that throw to change it up.
Absolutely. How's the Chile D-line looking for this point? Have they changed it up?
They calling names on there. Castelblancos and Rogacki have played a lot of offensive points joining them.
Yeah.
Gant, very quick. Michael Lau, incredibly quick. Real hustler. Osmond, very tall, athletic rookie recruited from Quidditch.
Yeah, right.
Representing Australian Quidditch. He played pre-season with Hoss before and tried out for both teams before being selected for this team with Chile.
Yeah, right.
They're joined by Lacombe, player coach, and Steve Thomas.
Liam Grund, Katrine, centering Elliot Cook. Elliot Cook to Alice looking big. Pick called. Elliot Cook with disc in hand. Oh, Elliot Cook, that saw count's going getting high. Gets it to Lock Bond, takes it one-handed. That was impressive. Goes to Joel Cook. Joel Cook back to Elliot. Elliot Cook to Lock Bond. Lock Bond to Elliot Cook. Elliot's looking deep. Hits Al Leisk. Hits Liam Grimmond. And the call's been made.
Grimmond's first touch for the point there. It's been hiding in the stack.
For someone as tall as he can. Grimmond to Elliot Cook. Elliot Cook sends it. Oh, Al Leisk takes it. Was he in? I think he's calling he was in and fell out.
She can help you on the line.
Thank you. Thanks, Tom.
The line advisor joining the call there. Just give a perspective. Well, I loved that that fake from Elliot Cook moving his mark so that he had the shot.
Yeah.
Very measured and planned.
Yep.
Yeah, I really felt like the defensive pressure was some of the best defense we've seen from Chile so far.
Yeah, definitely. Definitely. There must have been some really high stall counts there. But they managed to get out of it, so great composure and taking great options, I guess. But it's not going to be enough for Chile just to maintain that level of intensity on D. They're going to have to find something special. And they're going to have to find it pretty quick.
Lapari joining that offensive line.
and that Mammoth line is not short. Dan Gladish with the pull.
Pulls a little bit shorter than what he hoped.
Possibly. Still got good time to set up though.
Scuba over the top. Yes, finds the space. Mike Kelly finds DeBell again. Just steps through that cup. First look every time. Papari, young RMIT player. Second season with this team. Rigaki, you hear the call of thrower. Everyone knows the threat that he is. But there's heaps of space for that scuba. DeBell looking for the break side. Another scuba to Kelly.
How many overheads was that? Three?
I think three. Well used.
Well, I mean, Mammoth can't be upset with that defensive effort. Like, if you're forcing your throws to go overhead, that's what you want.
Look, they did, but it was pretty short, safe scubas.
Yeah, absolutely.
That you'd expect to hit. Not a very high level of risk needed by Chile. That final scuba from DeBell, obviously, that little bit more.
Yeah, so that's 9-5 to Mammoth.
Yeah, we've seen after half time just that intensity we're talking about, just they need to bring it. Need to lift it up. They've got the skills.
Absolutely.
I'm absolutely loving Josh DeBell's game.
Yeah, he's had some really quick movements there and some great throws. There's certainly a lot of throwers on this line right now for Mammoth. Chris Bowne, Seb Brownlee, McIntyre, Luke Bain, Timothy's Copland, Sam McGuckin, and Rob the Hollander. Liam McIntyre with the disc now. Sends it to Luke Bain. Luke Bain goes back to Leon. Hit Seb Brown, Sam McGuckin. Sam McGuckin to Rob De Hollander. Centers to Chris Brown. Chris is his brother Seb. Seb to Leon. Leon to Sam McGuckin, the call.
Look, home stopping pretty early there, so they're having a discussion to whether it affected, but we're pretty confident that it did.
Mm. Good call, quick resolution, coming back on one, I think. Leon looking. Oh, hits Luke Bain. Not sure where the defender was on Luke Bain.
It was a pick call.
Pick call, right.
Yes, it was. Suspicious from the start, way too much space. Does McIntyre have a third shot in him to the end zone?
Probably.
Hasn't been too shy so far.
Are we all good here or? So you need to talk to him about that, not me. Still count.
Goes to the round.
Copland. Seb Brown. Seb Brown's looking. Centers back to Leon McIntyre. Big high release to Rob De Hollander. Do we have another call? No? Yes? No?
It was pick central, but it was retracted.
All right. Okay. Third time's a charm. Rob De Hollander, Townsville debutant for the Mammoth boys. as is Tom Anderson. This is actually the first year Mammoth are taking non-Brisbane-based players. Well, actually, you could say non-Southeast Queensland-based players. So it's never happened before, even back in the days of Firestorm. So it's really exciting to see that. Both of them were on the Queensland Under-22 squad. So Tim McLeese was their head coach. So he was obviously impressed with what he saw from them and made the case to the Mammoth leadership to bring him in. And here they are, the quarterfinals against Hot Chili.
I believe those guys, did one or both of them play Div 2 with Townsville?
Yes, they did. They both played with Townsville. It was one of the exceptions that AFTA was happy to allow because it was a Div 2 player playing up to Div 1. Otherwise, they wouldn't have that opportunity.
So AFTA also had that assessment?
Yep. So I believe it's the national events manager that can that rules on all eligibility queries and requests. So they thought that it would be good because I think Rob Donald is also on the been invited to the second under 24 selection camp. So AFTA recognises this is a great development opportunity for him and happy to allow it. John McNaughton, what a pull!
Oh, that's the trouble. Oh, Chunker. Gets there, gets big.
Big pressure there. But Chili finding the holes straight away.
Bell to Rigaki in the centre, finds Lapari. Mr. Bell not on, but Rigaki to the overhead. Lapari just hanging up there in the zone to Bell. Rigaki following the disc. It's a fast disc so far. Mammoth now slowing down the play. They've gone to man. DeBell on the space, just getting in front of him. That fake not really distracting McNaughton all that much. Junker looking.
Tommy Anderson, great defense.
His arms stretching for miles. This match defense slowing down. That layout not coming early enough for DeBell.
Pretty close. It was a great effort, great bid. John McNaughton picking up, looking. Goes to Tommy Anderson. Back to John McNaughton. Trying to marshal them, trying to give them direction. Back to Tom Anderson. Tom having a look. Goes back to John McNaughton. John McNaughton hits Stu Jinx. Hits it to Liam Grimmond. Back to John McNaughton. John McNaughton calling people under. Mammoth offense stalling here a little bit. Back to Liam Grimmond. Grimmond to Tom Anderson. Tom Anderson to Chris Brown.
It's on the ankles and too much to reel in. That's a drop.
It is.
Solid pressure for Chili's.
Straight through the middle there.
Cool calm ahead of Baker. Breaks to Kelly. A renowned thrower. Dumps it to Rigaki. Finds Baker. He's looking to the open side. Gets down that one knee for the break to Rigaki. Oh no! Disc sitting,
just
sitting.
Loaded.
Rigaki can't believe it. That's another opportunity.
I think that's the big difference that we've seen this game so far. When Mammoth have had those turnovers from Chili, they've punished them. Chili not quite being able to do the same, although points still midway through.
It's in a fantastic matchup downfield between Grimmond and Allen.
It's been a call.
Yeah, Anderson's streaming. He was probably thinking he was found a pot of luck there. He was had 30 metres on Rigaki.
Uncontested indirect foul off the disc.
Oh.
Liam. I don't know how he kept that in. Gets it to John McNaughton, gets it to Jack Allen. Jack Allen to Sam McGuckin. Sam McGuckin goes big. Looking for Stu Jinks.
To the power position on the field.
Had position. Stu not being able to get off the ground there.
Yeah, it looks like there's some kind of contact just bothering him to his launch.
He was certainly thinking about it.
Yeah.
I think Mike Baker already had position there on that one.
Thanks for the perspective.
Oh, Chile with another chance to break.
Big huck to the space. Junker going long. Stretching and milks that with the roll, calls the timeout. Alan's a little bit disappointed. He thought he might have had the score there. But they'll take their time. I think that's their second timeout call of the day. We see that roll. Yep. Junker's been very safe hands, played very well today so far, holding the intensity level.
You could see he was lining up for it. He was at the start of that, as Gak was going to pick it up, he was already making his move, swinging out wide, just getting behind Stu Jinks there, and then he was gone. Stu couldn't catch up to him.
Seen a little bit of a different game at the moment. It has a different feel to it. Mammoth not getting as free as they were before.
Yeah, definitely. Certainly on this point, they've certainly stagnated offensively. They're sort of moving acrosswards, but not really going forwards too much. And then when they do, just getting boxed out by Chile. Do you think Chile stepped it up? Is that the difference from their defense?
Yeah, it's their intensity, and they've mixed up their lines a little bit more. But yeah, I just feel like there's a buzz, that little bit more of a buzz sound than we had in the first half.
Yeah.
Don't be fooled, 5-10 is a big score to come back from. But
not insurmountable.
Not insurmountable.
Not
yet.
Ideal, though. But if you're going to do it, no time like the present.
Gaki's sitting at the front of the stack. Who's that, Mike?
Is it McGuckin? 68?
McGuckin. Whether it's a decoy or the isolated player, faulty player. So typical to come out of those timeouts in play and see a turnover.
John McNaughton going for Chris Brown straight away.
Firing back, it's straight over his head.
He's going, he's got it. He's looking for support. Gets to Grimmin. Grimmin looking. Grimmin to J-Mac. J-Mac to Sam McGuckin.
And all that energy dissipates.
Boom.
That throwaway Mammoth taking back that control.
Yep. And punishing so quickly. C. Brown recognized straight away that John McNaughton was going to be picking up. John McNaughton's got the throw. Just making the most of their opportunities. So what happened with Chile in the end zone there? Just miscommunication or...?
It was crowded and it was kind of... I think the play was predicted pretty early on. They knew Rogacki was going to try isolate, so the players sat under.
Yep.
With the stack right behind him, that allowed them to cover both spaces.
Yep. So that's 11-5 to Mammoth.
I love that call from the sideline. The Mammoth boys, when they want to G each other up, they ask each other to invest.
Yeah, yep. I think it's been a pretty big mental change for Mammoth this season. Really having a supportive player base and supporting each other on and off the field. Always makes it easier to run, keep running when you've got an active sideline.
Castelblanco to Lacombe, to DeBell. Pretty different offensive line we're seeing here. DeBell, that zone, shutting down the movement so far. DeBell to Baker. Gonna keep on ticking along. Hammer over the top, it's finds Thomas. Had to work. All of Chile's players sucked into the under zone here. Allowing the defense to close in. Hectic space.
Not only the defense, but the deeps and the wings. It's like there's so many players there now. Now we've got a Chile player stretching deep.
Okay, this is a tough space. Thomas finds Lacombe connecting with him. DeBell wants overhead. Thomas doesn't want to throw that, but he finds Castelblanco through the cup. DeBell causing the space. Oh, this is all side one at the moment. They're really struggling to get it off that side one.
Yep.
Combs disc in hand. Body contact coming through the cup. They're not afraid. Must be late stall and contact.
I feel like I was pretty stationary. I felt like you pivoted into my leg, but I'm not sure how, if I was dead stationary or whether it was some movement.
I don't think you were dead stationary from where
okay,
I was looking at.
Okay, fair enough.
Not even looking at
it. I'm going to foul.
Sorry.
Yeah, that's right.
Uncontested foul.
You have to mark. That's fine.
Yeah,
I was moving and
just
contact, so whatever.
Uncontested foul. Yeah, coming in on one. We all good?
I find McIntyre very good at simplifying the conversation and getting the resolution.
Absolutely. And he's certainly one of those players. He doesn't mind if he's wrong.
Oh, it's big. Oh, what a throw. That's a precious point there. It's right in that corner. They were there. Lacombe obviously sick of that. He has the tools in the toolbox. We probably haven't seen them as much so far, but he saw the field, saw the space.
Yeah, absolutely. Good option, though. So 11-6 to Mammoth. The sideline was certainly really, really loud there for both Chile and Mammoth there, especially when they were on that sideline. It was getting pretty hectic.
Yeah, it's both squads choosing the close sideline to the heart of this game.
Absolutely.
It's noisy over here.
Which is good to see, because I don't think we've seen a lot of that from Chile this game. They've been very, very, very quiet.
Offensive line looking like Chris?
That's a good question. I see Lockbon, Al Leese, Elliot Cook, Lock Murph, Linus Muller, who's behind? I think it's Finn McCarthy, and John McNaughton.
McNaughton and Cook in early times at SMO playing separate lines. Played a few points together here.
Cook picking up to John McNaughton. He's looking. Goes to Al Lisk. Al Lisk sends it to Finn. That's
ambitious.
Yeah.
With the leaning back forehand, freeze.
Yep.
He had a big ask with Rigaki sitting deep as well.
A lot of things had to go right there.
Big force from Murphy here. Around, they're pushing the limits a little too much.
Alice picks up. He sends it deep.
Lacombe intercepting.
Chile scrambling, moving to hit that space.
The open space to Osmond.
Gap sends it deep. Foul called.
Uncontested foul.
Been watching that defender Murphy in earlier games. Very, very impressive young player. Marking up against a absolute champion veteran of the game. Fantastic.
Yeah, absolutely.
For him. Look for the break, finds Thomas. Thomas very effective this game. Baker, DeBell, lots of calls of those names this game. Lacombe, back to DeBell. Keep moving down that line. Casta Blanco puts it to the space for Osmond. Boom, 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 and they're back on the scoreboard.
Indeed. So 11-7 to Mammoth. Hot Chili slowly making a dent into that lead. Down to 4 now.
That force downwind being the backhand force for the right-hander. But they're very capable throwers, and they're just moving it down that line. They don't look to centre it as much as other teams do. Osmond is such a big receiver in the end zone. That stretch.
Yeah. And he's got hops as well. So it looks like Mammoth have completely changed their O-line. They've got Chris Brown, Luke Bain, Leon McIntyre, Seb Brown, Jack Allen, Timocles Copeland, and Sam McCucket. I guess that's the joys of a big squad. You can do full line subs. Here we go. Massive pull there from the back gap. Seb Brown picks up, goes to Leon McIntyre. Back to Seb Brown. Seb back to Leon McIntyre. To Jack Allen, back to Leon. To Luke Bain. Luke Bainey to Sam McGuckin. Back to Leon McIntyre. Seb Brown back to Leon. McIntyre looking. Seb Brown to Timocles Copeland. I think that's his first touch this point. Seb Brown up to Sam McGuckin. Man, they are loving the sideline. Seb Brown to Leon McIntyre. Leon back to Timocles. Timocles to Leon McIntyre. Back to Timocles, back to Leon. Foul called. This Chile defense is lifted.
It's probably a rush call. I don't really
want to contact
you, but really, I
step on
your feet.
So. Okay, let's keep it going here. Retracted call.
It's great to see the Chile defense certainly seems to have stepped up a notch.
Pressure is on.
Leon to Luke Bain. Bain's looking.
Huge mark from Osmond.
Back to Leon, back to Luke Bain. Mammoth looking to center, but to Jack Allen.
Finally find some space.
Jack Allen, Seb Brown. Back to Leon. Back to Timocles. Timocles to Sam McGuckin. To Leon McIntyre. Leon to Timocles, back to Leon, to Luke Bain. Back to Leon. Timocles Copland, to Jack Allen. Jack Allen, Luke Bain, Luke Bain to the end zone. Maybe not quite. Wow.
Patience, what a point.
Yep. They got stuck on that sideline and they just kept working it, kept moving it around. They had a few holes and then once they finally got through that center, down the other sideline and into the end zone. That I need a drink after that.
It's an intense cup. Pressure.
Osman
and McIntyre battle. I love it. Those two keep on coming matched up against each other. Two big guys. The cup there, Chile, they sit... The second player in the cup sits quite a lot in front of the thrower, meaning that swing to the open side, there's a few gainers there, which allowed for... To stop that Lacombe on that wing, moving a long way under plane very, very aggressively, and early on we saw swings around him to the space. The centre trying to call him back, trying to go for the poach on the inside. It's a really hard working position with a lot of holes there. Didn't cost him too much there, but there are holes down this close sideline.
Yeah, and that was certainly great effort by Chile at that point.
Yes.
I hope they keep it up.
Yeah.
Because that's what they needed to do from the start, I would imagine.
Once they got to this sideline, that was ideal.
Yeah. John McDaughton with a pull with a ridiculous hang time there.
Pete Allen doesn't usually find himself cashing pulls. Pick call.
Pick called.
Junker, lefty forehand, stuck in the sideline again, common theme, finds Rikaki with a dumb forehand. Down the line to Lapari. Trying to get rid of this, finds Junker working hard, wouldn't expect anything less. Down the line. Rikaki want more space, bullet to Baker. Junker everywhere.
Absolutely. So it's 12-7 to Mammoth, I believe.
Twelve eight. Pressure on this sideline. Thought Chile's younger players, Kelly, Lapari, held very well up under
absolutely.
That pressure.
Definitely.
And you can expect that cool head from Gaki, Baker, Junker.
Absolutely. I do like how Mammoth are not afraid to put their whippersnappers onto the Chile vets.
Yes.
That's a massive confidence boost. So, we'll give you that responsibility if we feel you can get the job done.
Yeah.
for Mammoth, we've got Joel Cook, Ryan Garrahy, Elliot Cook, Alec Leesk, Lock Murph, Linus Miller, John McNaughton, Pete Allen with the pull. Looks short, looks like it'll be a roller. Elliot Cook picking up centre into John McNaughton.
That zone on again. There's an early throwaway from McNaughton. Castablanco wants to move it on fast, finds Baker in the centre. Really want to use this opportunity. Castablanco settling with the disc behind play. Picking up in the air.
Ryan Garrahy brings it down for Mammoth.
Oh, the pressure cooker just too much there for Chile.
Elliot Cook with the disc to Linus Muller. Back to Ryan Garrahy. Ryan out to Joel Cook. Sends it to John McNaughton. Sends it to Elliot Cook. Hits Al Leesk. Back to Elliot. Elliot sends it. Lock Murph in the end zone.
Oh, that hurts for Chile. But fantastic rebound.
Absolutely, they had their chance, they had their shot. Could have broken again. They had field position as well. Just a simple execution error with the throw.
Say execution error, but players, like, the defense was on their head. It was very, very tight for Mammoth. They responded on transition quickly. The play again. The only space was behind the disc. Castablanco falling back, looking for the comb, pushing the throw a little bit too much.
So 13-8 to Mammoth. Mammoth D-line looks like Dan McPherson, Finn McCarthy. Oh, I'm struggling to see these guys. Is that Trent? Trent Thompson, Dan Gladish, Linus Muller, Al Leesk, and John McNaughton.
Lacombe joining this offensive line, actually.
Ball.
DeBell collects on the end of the end zone. Rogacki on the downward side. Forcing towards his close sideline. Rogacki, fake. To the space. Junker reels it in, he's on the end zone line. Last time he was here, he called a timeout. Not this time. Series of jinx from Lacombe doing the job, getting free, finding himself free for that the little pass to the end zone. That's the score.
13-9. Once again, Gak playing a pretty pivotal role at that point. Chile sending that big throw deep.
Oh, he's the master at moving his defender around.
Absolutely. I didn't think he was going to get that throw off. I think it was Linus on defending him, was straight up on him. But still somehow managed to move him out and just pivot and just... Was that nearly full field huck?
That push pass from Junker. Close in space. The score's still down, but I feel like... the sideline energy from Chile has grown and grown.
Yeah, definitely.
It feels like they're in the game. and they really want to give it their best shot. It's, I mean, it's quarters. It's your last chance.
Absolutely.
Here we go, my man! Let's go, Chile! Let's go, Chile!
Still not an insurmountable task for Chile to make it back. Here we go, game on. Point on even, sorry. Seb Brown, Leon McIntyre. Oh wow, Rob De Hollander. Chile forcing Mammoth to that sideline again. Mammoth really struggling to move away from the sideline. There we go, Leon McIntyre, Luke Bain. Luke Bain back to Leon. Leon to Seb Brown, Seb Brown to Chris Brown, Chris Brown, Sam McGuckin to Luke Bain.
The go is too much. There's so much space. Huge let off from Mammoth. Gacky jacks the disc. It's up, Thomas Copeland. The end zone. Oh, Thomas comes down with it.
Wow.
Oh, that's a huge take. What a play.
Wow. Held his line, went up high, took it at its highest point, and it was enough to get over Timocles Copeland. Score clarification? Is that what that discussion was about? Yeah, right. Mammoth just need to hold hard. Put their O in. Be patient.
That was fascinating, that zone. De Hollander sitting in the end zone on his own. Rigaki with the confidence. He sat right in the middle of the field, a good 50 metres away.
Yeah, absolutely. I thought as soon as Chris Brown had the disc, I thought he was going to send it to Rob De Hollander, but chose to centre it.
Look, it worked. I mean, it was rush in the end, which hurt Mammoth rather than the defensive pressure, but turn to turn, scores to score.
That's it. Very similar looking line to the last one, actually. Leon McIntyre, Jack Allen, Liam Grimmond, Sam McGuckin, Chris Brown, Timocles Copeland.
Victor Pukko marking McIntyre. Hasn't played too many points this game. He's fresh legs.
Mammoth getting pushed to that sideline again.
Josh! Josh again! Nice, Josh! Yes, Josh!
This is Chile defense in the first half.
I feel like I was pivoting that way, and my leg got bumped inside as I bumped in the field.
I couldn't see from there, but you just need to remember you have to be legally positioned in order for it not to be a foul by you. So.
Uncontested.
Zero.
That's a really good question, Chris. I'm absolutely loving this second half. Pressure is on. Pukko's a huge mark at the moment.
John
McNaughton, the pressure's
goes
up
to Sam McGuckin.
Can he get on
there?
That disc and
oh my
in.
Goodness. He's got options. Who's he going to go with? Looks for his dump. Goes to John McNaughton. Wow. Wow. I mean, if you throw it forward, it's still a dump, right?
Let's go, boys!
14-10 to Mammoth.
Oh, we're in the pressure cooker. I'm loving this intensity.
Absolutely. Chile is running out of time.
John, was that Elliot saying, put Sam D?
No, I saw Sam before that. Okay. I'm not going to give me the
It was a great take from McGuckin.
Absolutely. There was not a lot of space between his hand and the ground, that's for sure. Great display of athleticism.
McGuckin gave him space, and without that athleticism, that space was completely warranted, but he was able to pull it in.
That's right. Mammoth D-line. Elliot Cook, Tim McLeese Coplins, Stu Jinks, Trent Thompson, Linus Mueller, Lachlan Murph, and Dan McPherson.
Early in this game, Chris, I really had no idea how Chile was going to get scores off Mammoth. Regular scores, but it's this intensity, and the rest of the teams will take note of that.
Absolutely. Oh, it's a great ball by Elliot there.
Gaki upfield, up inside the field. It's a travel call.
It's alright, I'll trust you and then blame you later.
Come on, boys!
Store count coming in at 3. Rigaki swings it to Castablanca. Generally safe hands. Rigaki found himself on the opposite wing now. Through to Baker, through to Castablanca. Okay. Keeps that moving.
Coming on 0.
Contested foul. Around the cup to Castablanca. Wants that end zone. Holds on. It's tight. It's tight. Around.
Toes the line. Wow.
Steve Thomas toes very carefully. Keeps him in the game.
Absolutely. That was intense defense there from that cup.
You don't often see Rigaki struggling to get around a mark.
No.
He's got such a reach, but Mueller there, just as much reach, and forcing Rigaki down that line every time around the cup instead.
That's right, and every time Gak looked up, he had Stu Jinks standing right in front of him, and then in the middle he had Tim McLeese Copeland.
That's a tough defensive lineup to come up against.
I'm glad I don't play Div 1.
So here we are with Mammoth on offense, the chance to score.
14-11.
If Mammoth take this point, they're off to the semis.
So, looks like Dan McPherson, John McNaughton, Liam Grimmond, Lock Murph, Alex Leisk, Sam McGuckin, and Elliot Cook.
Defense, Allen, Castablanco, rookie Osmond, got Rigaki, Combe, DeBell, Thomas.
Big point for Chile right now. Gak puts it up. That is sailing. Great catch. Centers to John McNaughton. Here's Liam Grimmond. He's got two going deep. Doesn't get the shot off. Sam McGuckin is there for him. Dumps to John McNaughton. Swings out to Lock Murph. Lock Murph to Dan McPherson. Lock Murph.
And
foul called?
Foul called.
Uncontested foul.
Stall count coming in one. Uncontested.
Lock Murph. Dumps to Elliot Cook. Elliot Cook to Liam Grimmond. Back to Elliot Cook to Lock Murph. Lock Murph to Dan McPherson. Pick called. Dan McPherson gives it to Al Leisk. Al Leisk to Liam Grimmond. Liam looking deep. Hits Lock Murph. Lock Murph back to Liam Grimmond. Foul called. Liam to Lock Murph. Lock Murph to Al Leisk. Alex to Liam Grimmond. He's got people down in the end zone. Sam McGuckin, he's got it in.
Ticket to the semi-finals. What an offense.
Wow.
Offensive point.
Patience. Chile had great intensity at that point. They've had great intensity this half, to be honest.
It's been fantastic play at that point. McNaughton trusting his young guns to keep the disc moving and him moving himself downfield. Those boys with the ability to find space consistently. So impressive. Really, that second half showing the best of Australian Ultimate. We've got veterans, we've got young guns, both ends of the spectrum.
Absolutely.
And defensive pressure. Chile looking like a whole different team in the second half.
Yep.
And that's shown in the result, coming back 15-11 rather than the earlier gap that was shown.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. Mammoth to the semis. I think we actually know the result of the other games.
We're just hearing the siren on the other field, so those games will be finishing up. Check the website, AFDA website events, for updates on the scores. Keep track of which game is next. We're going to have, women's semi-finals next. Looking forward to that. Thanks, Chris, for joining on the stream.
Thanks for having me, mate.
My name's Stefan Van Boxdale, and it's been absolute pleasure bringing you to this game. Stay tuned for the next stream.
Catch up.